Now, to finish our section today, we see what is always the case when people are getting saved. We see the anger of the enemies of the gospel, verse 13. But when the Jews from Thessalonica learned that the word of God was preached by Paul at Berea, they came there also and stirred up the crowds. Then immediately the brethren sent Paul away to go to the sea, but both Silas and Timothy remained there, and those who conducted Paul brought him to Athens, and receiving a command for Silas and Timothy to come to him with all speed, they departed. And we're going to look at Paul in Athens next week. But notice again, Jews from Thessalonica, nothing better to do, but they hear the gospel is being preached in Berea. We can't have that. So they leave their lives over there to come and cause trouble somewhere else. Now, at least with the Jews doing it in this context, we understand they were zealous for their scriptures. They hated that Paul, through their scriptures, was preaching Jesus. So while it's not proper, we at least understand their mindset. But again, what is the mindset of someone who thinks, oh, that Bible, that's filled with myths and legends and fairy tales and lies? Then what are you afraid of it for? Do you want to censor Aesop and Grimm and these other fairy tale writers, right? No. We want to censor this. We want this out of influence. But if it's just a bunch of lies and fairy tales, and how can anyone be so stupid as to believe it, then why are you afraid of people reading it? Let them have a good laugh. So what we see, and you know what the answer is when I ask why, the answer is also told us in the Bible. It's because there is a spiritual war taking place. And this war that we are fighting is not against other flesh and blood. It's not against that ACLU lawyer. It's not against some atheistic politician that's causing problems. No. It's against spiritual powers in high places, and their commanding general is the devil himself. And the war is over the souls, the immortal, priceless soul, a soul that Jesus said, what would a person give in exchange for their soul? The whole world would be a bad bargain. And there's a fight over the soul of every single person on this earth. Many of us have already had the victory that's found in Jesus. And once we've trusted in Jesus as our Savior, once we've believed that He died for our sins and He rose from the dead for our forgiveness, once we have done that, then we are assured. He says, I'll never leave you, I'll never forsake you. All that the Father's given me, I won't lose a single one of them. Praise the Lord. But some are still in the battle. And the worst thing that you can do is to be stirred up in here today and then go out the doors, go get lunch, go turn on that Padres game, or, you know, get ready to set your DVR for American Idol this week or whatever. And then kind of just let it fade away. God's Spirit stirs you up to your need for Christ. And the devil will say, tomorrow, don't worry about it. And it'll be forgotten if you let it. If you have any doubt about your personal faith in Christ, if you wonder if you're His child, if you wonder if you died, if you'd be with Him, then don't leave here with that doubt. Please come up and talk to me. We'll talk. We'll answer questions. Again, the Bible's got all the answers. If you have to leave, then fire off an email. Do it as soon as you get home so you don't forget. We'll talk by computer if we have to. I'm not going to save you, but I'll tell you what, I will answer every question that you possibly have, and whatever question you might have, believe me, you're not that original. It's probably been asked 20 times already to me, thousands of times throughout history. God loves you. Don't leave here. Don't leave here swallowing the lies that the world has fed you, that you're an accident of chance and just a highly evolved primate. From this goo through the zoo to you. That's the lie of the devil. Let's pray.